Welcome to airsofttech.dk. In this episode, I will show you how simple it is to make the electronics that goes into a tracer unit. In the next couple of episodes, the knowledge will be used to make a couple of different style tracer units. As always, more details can be found on the project page linked in the description below. Now let's get started. Now the first thing I want to do to this buck converter is to adjust this tiny little screw here. This tiny little screw right there sets the output voltage. So first I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna turn it all the way to the right. That's the lowest setting. So now it's turned all the way clockwise. So now I want to adjust the pin to reach the forward current of 3.4 volts or maybe slightly below. So I turn on my altimeter and set it for voltage and I hook it up to the output pins. And when I have hooked up the buck converter to the output pins, I hook up the input power to the battery. And when this is done, I can see on my multimeter what the voltage, output voltage of the buck converter is. So right now, the output voltage is 0.5 volts. And we are reaching for around 3 point something volts, at least 3, but maybe a bit more. So now I turn it counterclockwise until I reach the 3 volts mark or slightly above. And it has to be below 3.4 volts because the LED that I have bought is a 3.4 volts forward voltage LED. So with the voltage set, I don't need the voltmeter anymore, so we can set that aside. And for now, just disconnect power so that we can assemble the rest. So now that we have set the buck converter to 3.4 volts or slightly below, we need to hook up the LED. The LED has two parts, two pins, a long one and a short one. The long one is usually connected to the side where there is just a small metal pin. On the other side there's a big chunk of metal inside and that is the output. So you can say this is goes to the positive side and this goes to the negative side. So the long pin goes to the output port, to this port. So this is to the output. And then the negative side from here goes to the negative side of the buck converter. And now when we hook up power, the LED should light up.
So that's how you hook it up. Now I have this small tiny push button and I'm gonna hook that up as well. So what I do is I take that small push button and I move the ground over to one side of the push button and then take the other side of the push button and connect back to ground. So now the LED won't light up until I touch the push button. So now I have hooked up this button so that I can control the LED just temporarily, just to show you how it works. And I have this small bag of tracer BBs. So let's take them. Hold them in front of the LED, give them some power, and you can see they start glowing. Let's do that again. And as you can see, even with just a small flash, they take up a pretty good charge. So, that's the basics of the tracer unit. So now let's wire everything back up together. We have the buck converter, and instead of the push button we have a small toggle switch. We have the wires, some solder, and we have this clamps to hold things for me instead of using my hands. So first we're gonna take the buck converter, and we need to give it some power. See here, there is markings on the back showing the direction of it. This is the input and this is the output. We want to wire the switch into the negative side, so let's do this. Now let's hook up the switch. So now we have input power, plus and minus, stay there, input power plus and minus hooked up to the switch. So now we need the diode to hook that up. Hook that up directly, just as we showed you in the video. Bend the pins a bit. Focus on this. That's the small tracer unit. So now it's time to test it out. So now let's test it. Use the battery just as before. By the way, this is a 2-cell LiPo battery. Hook up ground, black wire, power, red wire, and now we have the switch to turn it on, switch to turn it off. So, turn it on, we turn it on, we can eliminate the trace arounds. It takes just a second to eliminate them. And turn it off again.
That was the basics on how to make a tracer unit. Now all you have to do is put the electronics into your gun. There are two ways of installing it. One is to install it into your hub-up feeding tube. Another way is to fit it into a suppressor-style unit. The next episodes will show you how to make the two different style installations. And remember, if you want more details on parts, options, or information on how it all works, go to airsofttech.dk for more information. Or you can go find the link in the description below. Thank you for watching.